guys, I'm starting this video for the second time just because I didn't really like how it's going. I don't know if you guys do that, but anyway, I am 9 months and 3 days post-op vertical sleeve gastrectomy surgery. I had surgery January 26, 2017 in Salt Lake City, Utah. You guys know I don't name my surgeon because I'm not a fan of my surgeon. So, anyway, I talked to you guys last week about like a reverse diet, which is something that bodybuilders do. And I guess other people, you know, that are trying to get into shape do it too when they've been dieting for a long time and they stop losing weight. Their body becomes stuck and they get to a standstill. And the reason why they get to a standstill is because dieting for such a long period of time, especially with a lot of exercise, specifically cardio, I guess they're saying that that can actually slow down your metabolism. And so I'm not doing any kind of a structured thing, but I've been doing a little bit of like, we'll say research, but really I've been watching YouTube videos and I think I read maybe an article on it. About reverse dieting. Basically, it's slowly increasing your calorie intake and, you know, carbs and whatnot. It as means to jumpstart weight loss again once you start to cut back. So basically, it's like raising your threshold or whatever, giving you some room to go back down. So basically, if I'm eating 1200 calories and I'm not losing weight and I cut down to 1000 calories, I may initially lose weight, but then I may stop losing weight again. So then my next option is to cut back to what, like 900 or 800 calories to increase my cardio. And basically, there's just a point where your body is just going to stop losing weight and you're going to get to a point where you have gotten too low on your calories and you're doing too much exercise. I can tell you, I was kind of in that space kind of earlier on. I got stuck for a while when I was in the 170s and I was probably eating between 600 and 800 calories a day, and I was exercising. I was like going for walks with my arm weights, and you know, I was pretty vigorous. And then I was also running up the stairs with my weights, three flights of stairs at work, and I would do that multiple times in a day. And I got to a point where I wasn't feeling good, so I made an appointment with a new surgeon. I was feeling dizzy, and I actually had one time where I passed out. I was standing up, I put my hands over my bed, over my head, and luckily my husband was standing there and he was able to catch me, but I passed out. And that was also because my blood pressure was too low, and I didn't realize I had low blood pressure because I always had high blood pressure before, and nobody had I hadn't been taking off my blood pressure meds. So I was taking blood pressure meds and I had low blood pressure. So that, the combination of not eating enough, made me pass out, and it was really scary. And the internist I see, who's my primary care doctor, he takes like 3 months to get into. So I made an appointment with another bariatric surgeon because I had had a bad experience with the office where like the surgeon who did my surgery was. So yeah, if you guys have watched my previous videos, you know I've talked a lot about that. But anyway, I got to a point where I was stalled, and went in and talked to the the new doctor, who I knew because I actually used to work for her. And I also talked to the dietitian and their exercise physiologist. And they told me I wasn't eating enough. They told me I need to eat between 800 and 1,000 calories. And they said that they didn't want me exercising yet. So once I increased my calories, I felt better. I haven't been dizzy as much. I still get dizzy, and it could be like, I've heard a lot of people get the orthostatic hypotension, where when they stand up, their blood pressure drops. My blood pressure has been like normal or sometimes low. And if you have low blood pressure, you want to drink a lot of fluids and have something salty, is what I've heard and read. So, but anyway, I went past the 1,000 calories, and when I started to eat more, and I got to a point where I was between 1,200 and 1,300 calories and felt good. By the way, once I had increased my calorie amount, I did start to lose weight again. Obviously, because I was in the 170s, and now, as of yesterday, I forgot to tell you guys this, I'm sorry. As of yesterday, I was 154.8. But anyway, so I have been in a place where like my body has gotten stuck because I wasn't eating enough. And I feel like if I had gone back to the surgeon who did my surgery, they probably would have told me to cut back on certain things, to exercise more. Whereas the other surgeon told me I need to eat more, and they didn't want me exercising yet, especially with the way I wasn't feeling well and had passed out. So when I went to see my internist, he had suggested that he wanted to make sure that I was eating enough, and he had suggested that I drink Gatorade when I work out, because I wasn't really going to give up working out. I don't work out, too strenuously, even still. This last week has been a lazy week for me. I haven't felt well. I think that it's just, I think I've just been on my period. I am at a point where I have an IUD, and I am at a point where I'm not really bleeding a lot. I had like one day of like moderate bleeding. Sorry if that's TMI, but then I haven't really been bleeding, but it's still, my body is going through things. And during this time, I have noticed that I get really tired and achy and moody and anxious. I get really anxious during my period. So it's just not been like the best week for me physically. So I was pretty lazy with the exercise. I still did my little routine that I've been doing 4 days this week. And I've talked a little bit about this, but basically it consists of squats. I do squats like with my feet pointing forward, and my kettlebell. I do about 15 of them, and then I turn my feet outward and do another 15 with my kettlebell. I think my kettlebell is like 15 pounds. It's not a huge one. It might be a little more than that. I can't remember, but anyway, my hair's crazy. Sorry about my hair, but I do that, and then I do some ab exercises, well, and butt exercises. Like, I don't know what they're all called. I think they're called bridges, where you lay on your back and you like lift up your hips. That's supposed to be a butt exercise. And then I do some crunches, and then some side crunches, and then I do, I don't know what this one's called either, I'm sorry. I just got it off of a workout video that's supposed to be for your butt. You get on all fours, and then you kind of kick your leg up. And then there's another one, you I don't know how to explain this, I'm a dork. So I put my elbows, like my arms down on the bed, but I'm still kind of on all fours. And then I do this with my leg, basically. I'll look at all that loose skin. So yeah, I do those, and then I do the one that's like a dog peeing on a hydrant, where you're on all fours and then you just lift your leg up. So I do those, and then I get up, and I've been doing this one. It's supposed to be a standing ab exercise where you just punch the air, so I do that. And then another one where, like, it's another ab exercise where you just pull your, like, arms down and, like, lift your knee up in the air. So kind of like a standing crunch. And then sometimes I do a little more squats. And then I also do arm exercises with my kettlebell, lifting it up like this. And then like this. Sorry about all the loose skin. It is what it is though. So I do that, and then some days I will do the stairs at work. We have 3 flights of stairs, and I'll just jog up those. You know, I've done them up to like 10 times a day. Sometimes I'll just do them a few times. It just depends on how I'm feeling. I didn't really do the stairs much this week, but I did my, you know, my little routine in the morning, you know, sometimes modified, sometimes I don't feel like doing some of the exercises. That's what I did as far as exercise this week, which is not as much as I normally do. And again, before it got cold, I was doing like sprinting and then walking spurts before work for about 10 minutes. So it's not a crazy amount of exercise, but it is something. Yesterday was really busy for me. I just wanted to get everything taken care of so that today would be more of a relaxing day, because I hate putting stuff off until Sunday, and then it feels like I didn't really have a weekend because I just did so much. But I went to Target yesterday, and I got some things for my costume. I'm gonna be a unicorn. Hopefully, if I can make the horn, I've got to do that today. I'll post pictures on Instagram. Again, if you want to follow me on Instagram, please do. Maybe I'll include a picture in my next week's video. Just leave your Instagram name in the comments, and I'll find you, and then you can add me. My Instagram is private. I have pictures of my family and stuff on there, so. Anyway, so yeah, I went to Target, I got a couple groceries as well. There's certain things that I like to buy there. I'm a coupon shopper, I use the Cartwheel app, and I try and look at the ads and shop based on that stuff. With shopping to get the best deals, I usually end up going a couple of different places. So I went to Target, and then I went to Smith's, which is Kroger, and did the rest of the grocery shopping. And I came home, did dishes and laundry, and I did a little bit of like cleaning up. So it was just like a busy day, and I was pretty sore and tired by the end of it. I got a lot done. And then today I'm just gonna be making breakfast for my husband and I, and we're gonna watch more Stranger Things, which we started last night. It's on Netflix, really good. So we're gonna watch more of that and just see how the day goes. But yeah, anyway, back to weight loss stuff. So I kind of talked about like where I had been in the past as far as what I was eating and well, like how many calories I was eating and when I got stuck, and then increasing my calories actually helped me to start losing weight again. So I was stuck for a month and a half at 157 pounds. I had like a couple of days where I'd gotten lower than that, but like I just kept going up to 157 pounds and being stuck. And so I was like, you know what, I'm okay with where I'm at. Yesterday I did, when I was at Target, they had a couple of shirts that were on sale for $5. And I tried on a small and it actually fits. It fits snugly, but that's usually how I like to wear my clothes. But yeah, I was actually able to get into a size small. And then I wear size 4 jeans, but I have been able to get into a size 2. But don't really have money for new jeans right now, so that's gonna have to wait. But yeah, my 4s are getting a little baggy. I do have a pair of 6 pants that I still wear, and those are pretty loose on me too. But yeah, so I, at 157 pounds, you know, I had to start to really, you know, being there for so long, I had to really think about, you know, would I be okay with being at this weight? And the answer is yes, because I'm going to continue to exercise, and I think that my body will still change even if I don't lose more weight. But I saw a video by Morgan Losing about reverse dieting, and it was odd because like the week that I decided not to track, I also was like, you know, I'm not going to track, I'm going to eat what I want to. Well, after that week I dropped 3 pounds, and I thought it was just because I was sick, you know, and I was drinking, or yeah, I had the liquid cold medicine, and I thought, I'm just dehydrated, you know, this is probably just a fluke. But no, like, I ate more calories, I ate more carbs, and I lost 3 pounds. So I decided that I'm gonna give my body a break, because obviously my body wants more calories and more carbs to keep losing weight. And so yeah, then I started looking into this reverse dieting thing, and apparently in the beginning you may actually gain weight because you're eating more calories. So I'm not upset. I am a pound up from last week. I'm not upset about that. We are going to fluctuate. That's why I think it's so smart when people give themselves a goal range. You shouldn't have like necessarily a goal weight, because our weight fluctuates, and you shouldn't beat yourself up about a couple of pounds, especially when you're able to maintain within that couple of pounds. So my VSG confessional, she has a goal range, and I really like that idea. So I was thinking to myself this week, like, would I be okay with being in the 150s for the rest of my life, barring if my husband and I decide to have another baby in the future? And the answer is yes. I feel pretty good at this weight. The only thing that I'm not really happy with is my belly, but I do hope to have skin removal surgery at some point in the future. And so I'm not upset. If I stay in the 150s, like, I'll be fine with that. And if I get down to my goal, which is 145 pounds, then I'll be happy with that. So I'm not worried about like having gained a pound since last week. I mean, I think that's kind of a win. I've been eating what I want to, you know what I mean? More carbs, more calories. Again, I haven't been tracking, but I'm not, like, I'm just being a lot more liberal with what I'm eating. And, you know, I'm up a pound from last week. It's, you know, it's really not a big deal to me. If I start to, you know, get up to where, like, I was at 157, then I may cut back, you know. But they say that to get your body to a place where it can start moving again, sometimes you need to increase your calories, which is not something that, like, weight loss doctors generally tell you, you know. If I went and saw a bariatric surgeon right now, they'd probably tell me that I'm eating too many calories. And I don't know what they'd say about exercise, but I'm pretty sure they tell me I'm eating too many calories. But I talked to you guys last week, and my base metabolic rate is in the 1400s. So I was definitely eating below 1400 calories and not losing weight. And I, you know, 1400 is base metabolic rate, so that's before you count for any exercise or anything that you do during the day, you know. And I feel like I'm a pretty like up and active during the day, so you know, my like what I actually burn in a day is going to be higher than 1400, and I was eating below that and not losing weight. And then as soon as I start to increase calories and carbs, then I go down. So obviously, like, my body is telling me something, and I'm just trying to listen, and I'm trying to eat based on, you know, how I feel. I definitely can eat more than I used to be able to. I looked it up because I was a little worried, like, am I eating way more than other bariatric surgery patients? So I think they tell you that you should get up to, I think it's a half a cup of food, so 4 ounces at a time. I can eat 5 to 6 ounces at a time, depending on what it is. I mean, certain things, lighter foods, I can definitely eat more than that at a time. So like ice cream is a big slider food for me. I can eat more than that. I could eat probably about 3/4 of a cup of ice cream, maybe more. It's just usually when I get to that point, I'm like, okay, you know, it's time to put down the spoon. But other foods like meat, you know, especially if it's dense, I may be able to eat less than that. I mean, I'm still eating way less, obviously, than I used to be able to eat. I used to be able to eat, you know, almost a whole pizza myself in one sitting. And now I'm full off of, like, a slice of pizza. So, yeah. It's not a crazy amount. I think that it's an amount that I can live with, and everybody is going to be different in that aspect. Obviously, I'm eating more, so that may have something to do with it. I don't really follow the 30-minute rule with drinking. I try to sometimes, but other times I'm like, fuck it, I want to drink. It actually helps things. It feels like things go down better, you know, when I have a little bit of a drink. But it definitely pushes me to that like very full point. I still haven't gotten sick in the way like throwing up or anything like that when I'm eating. I've gotten nauseous and to the point where I feel like I need to throw up when I way overdid it with sweets a couple of times. But I haven't thrown up. Usually if I eat way too much, then I'm just achy and just really full. And I just don't feel good when I do that. But anyway, I'm just kind of rambling about a lot of stuff right now. One thing I did want to mention is if you like, or if you're starting to be able to eat more, just try and fill yourself up with things that are better for you. I'm not saying that this is like a good example, but when we'd go to McDonald's, like after surgery, when I got like a cheeseburger, at first I wasn't able to eat. I was probably only able to eat like half of just the patty with the cheese and stuff. Now I can eat 3/4 of a double cheeseburger. But the last time I went to McDonald's, I just got myself a single, and I ended up eating like probably like 10 fries, which is a lot more than I'm comfortable with. I also ate some of the bun. So I would say if you find yourself eating more, you know, go for the protein. Fill yourself up on the protein. Because normally if I get like a double cheeseburger, then I can eat, like I said, about 3/4 of it. And, you know, I eat like tomato and pickles, whatever is on the burger, bacon. I love bacon cheeseburgers. And then I may only have like 3 fries. And for me, that's a better compromise. I also try, most of the time I skip drinks when we eat fast food. It's just a lot of calories that I don't need. And the only things I can have really are lemonade and like fruit punch, and so those things get kind of tiring. So I don't usually get drinks. Every once in a while, if I feel like it, I will. If I want something different, but most of the time I don't. And then I just try and fill up on protein. That is my recommendation. When you feel yourself starting to be able to eat more, go for the protein. I'll tell you, because I love fast food. And it's a lot cheaper than like buying all the components to eat a good meal, but that's also important. So I think that it's a balance of, you know, eating cheap fast food that's not great for you and eating stuff that's healthier for you. I think that if you're gonna eat fast food, that you should have a balance. And mix it up and try and get vegetables in where you can. But I can tell you at Taco Bell, I really love the double chalupas. I don't know if they still have them, but basically I'd cut it in half and I would eat like half of the bread, which is like a Navajo taco, like flatbread, with all the yummy stuff in it. And so if you're gonna eat carbs, you know, like, you just limit them. I'm gonna make pancakes this morning and I'll probably only eat one pancake. When I made French toast, I ate one slice of French toast and an egg, you know, and I'll probably have some egg too, so that I get some protein in. But yeah, I'm gonna enjoy having a pancake. So, you know, I'm not telling you to go out and eat carbs by any means. I'm just telling you that it's not the end of the world if you do. It's okay to have some of these things in your diet in moderation. I think that's the majority of what, you know, I know I lacked, and probably other people as well, is not eating in moderation, you know, eating tons of food, the wrong foods, and then also lots of calories in the drinks that I was drinking. So I think, you know, if you're like incorporating, you know, carbs and stuff back in, just, I mean, your stomach, like your sleeve is gonna help you not be able to eat as much as you used to be able to, you know. But even if you haven't had weight loss surgery, just, you know, balance and moderation with what you're eating. And if you're able to eat more and still maintain your weight, that's a win. So I'm not saying that I'm done losing weight. I'm just saying that right now I'm pretty happy with where I'm at. One more thing that I'll mention to you guys, I got a new bra. I had to try on several bras because I didn't know where I was at anymore. I'm at kind of a weird place because I do have a lot of loose skin in my breasts. Before surgery, I was wearing like a 46 triple D. What I'm wearing right now is a 36D. And I feel like I could probably get into a C, but I have a lot of loose skin and the loose skin hangs out, and so I'm still wearing a size D, a cup size bra. But I got this at Target. It was $10, and I was happy to find a bra that fits, that's cute, that's comfortable, and affordable. So anyway, that's where I'm at. Yeah, you can kind of see, well, not one, but yeah, there's loose skin here, and still some fat in there. But I'm getting to a place where like I'm pretty happy with my body, except my belly, and I'm still like, my belly is slowly getting smaller. But yeah, 154 pounds. I'm 5'4", and I'm wearing a size 4 jeans and a small shirt. So I'm not unhappy with where I'm at, and I'm eating more. I'm eating more and I'm eating more carbs and I'm enjoying what I'm doing and I'm getting some exercise, and I think that's what it's all about. So yeah, I feel like I'm at a pretty good place, and I think that it's all about adjusting accordingly. If I start to, you know, if I keep going, keep the scale keeps going up, then, you know, at some point I will pull back. And I'm just gonna keep exercising moderately, and just live my life and enjoy myself. Anyway, hope you guys are doing well. Thanks for listening to all my rambling. Thank you to all the new subscribers, and thank you to all the subscribers that have been there from the beginning and everybody in between. I appreciate your support, and your comments. I'll talk to you later.